Hey guys, it's MJ, the Student Actuary, and today we're talking about the greatest rivalry in history. Greater than Coke versus Pepsi, greater than Australia versus South Africa, greater than David versus Goliath. Yes, we are talking about actuaries versus accountants. Both are global professions that control the world's financial systems. Accountants are guardians of capitalism, the knights of fiscal policy, and the champions of the business sector. But are they better than actuaries? To become an actuary, one needs to be incredibly analytical, comfortable with uncertainty, mathematically superior, phenomenal at communicating, intensely self-disciplined, have utmost integrity, and contain wisdom of the highest order. To become an accountant, you need to know how to turn on a calculator. Okay, sorry, I'm going to try not to be biased in this video. In fact, my brother is actually a chartered accountant and he's got his master's in finance. And I actually wanted to get him on this video to help me out with it, but he was too busy getting engaged because you see, accountants actually have social lives. We're actuaries, we have, let's move on. Traditionally, accountants used to be bookkeepers and they would simply record financial transactions. And traditionally, actuaries were clergymen who got very accurate at modeling how many people would die every year. Both developed into professional societies that would get embedded in financial regulation. In order to raise capital on the market, you would need a qualified accountant to sign off on your financial statements. In order to offer insurance, you need a qualified actuary to sign off your reserve capital. Basically, you can't do the big boy business without them, and that is why both are paid more than the minimum wage. But with great power comes great responsibility, which means you can't do a lot of this. If you want to be an actuary or an accountant, you basically have to say goodbye to the party life and sacrifice your young adult lives. Because to become an accountant or an actuary, not only do you need a 3 or 4 year university degree, but after this, you still have to do a lot more mind-bending exams, plus workshops, conferences, continual professional development. And on top of that, you also have to pay outrageously expensive fees to join. So much so that I think it's actually easier to get into the Illuminati or the Freemasons than it is to become an actuary or an accountant. But I must say, one thing about the logos of actuaries has got me thinking. I mean, what shape do they all seem to have? I mean, the Illuminati is a little bit synonymous with the triangle. I mean, you can even see a white outlined triangle on the South African logo. And yeah, I just thought it was weird. Although you might say, you know, someone who really knows their history, that the true Illuminati logo, you know, had the owl, which represented the wisdom. Which, when you look at the oldest actuarial emblem, the one of England and Scotland, you can see that they also have owls. I mean, what a wonderful coincidence that is, hey? Anyway, what was I talking about? The university. Okay, yeah, let's get back to university. Okay, what do you guys do in first year? Funnily enough, first year for both actuaries and accountants is very similar. Both will do a little bit of maths, a little bit of statistics, a little bit of accounting, a little bit of economics, and a little bit of finance. In fact, it's actually quite common for students to change their minds after 1 year of university and switch their degrees. Most of the time, we do see first year actuarial students switching to become second year accounting students because they think it's easier, but in reality, both of the degrees are equally difficult. In second year and beyond, we will see the accountants focusing more on accounting and business management, whereas the actuaries will focus more on statistics and risk management. After university, accountants have it much harder when it comes to their article period, where they get paid less, they work harder, they work longer, and they're very restricted on where they can work. Whereas actuaries have more freedom in their article period, but they do have to write more exams. All chartered accountants write the same board exams, in which there are two in total in South Africa, whereas actuaries have multiple exams, and the later exams are specialized, and they depend on what field the actuary wants to go into. So if two of you guys study actuarial science, in the later years, you might be writing different exams. Now, accountants can work in various positions in the office, but the highest position for them is the chief financial officer. Actuaries can also work in various business positions, and the highest position for them is this new thing known as the chief risk officer. Both can also become the chief investment officer, and both can also become the chief executive officer. Although accountants tend to fill the CEO position more than actuaries. And this does make the accountant feel more important because this role allows them to control global companies that shape the world economy. But some actuaries end up controlling the CEOs. I know you might be quite surprised to hear that. You see, some actuaries consult for massive pension funds who own the majority of shares in these companies. And they actually get to vote on the remuneration policy for the CEOs. So while at face value it might look like accountants control the world by controlling these large businesses, it's actually the actuaries who control the world, as they have the power over the CEO's bonus, so the CEO would be wise to obey the actuary. Although accountants do get the final laugh, as a CEO of a global corporate can be expected to earn £10 million a year, whereas an actuary is lucky if they get paid 10% of that amount. So I think let's end it off here with the salaries. Your average actuary will make more than your average accountant, but your top accountants dwarf your top actuaries. But both actuaries and accountants can get involved in wider fields. This is stuff beyond the traditional subjects. And for those of you who are subscribed to my channel, you know that I like cryptocurrencies. I've liked them so much that I've actually decided to go and make my own one. It's called Hypecoin, and it's a lot of fun. It's a little bit like Bitcoin, it's a little bit like social media. And what I'm busy doing is I'm running a beta just on Android, come up on Apple later. And there's just a limited space, but if you want to join and you know, test the app before I release to production, feel free to send me an email at founder@hypesocialcurrency.com. Or if you're watching this video after July 2017, check out the description because I might place a link to that app. Anyway, I'll make a proper video explaining Hypecoin later, but I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching. And let me know in the comment section below whether you want to become an accountant or an actuary and the reason why. Thanks guys. Cheers.